Are you considering buying life insurance or disability insurance? I know, you're Superman. Or at least you feel like Superman, so what could go wrong? But Superman might benefit from life and disability insurance as well. Superman's an alien, but he's not immortal. So he might want a life insurance policy that will cover the mortgage on his condo, pay for a super funeral, and maybe leave some money for his parents and Lois Lane if he dies. And Superman's monthly premiums wouldn't be all that bad. He's a healthy guy in his 30s. He's smoking, but he doesn't smoke. He does have a crippling allergy to green rock, but that's comparable to a nut or bee allergy, which generally doesn't affect premiums. Clark Kent's job as a reporter wouldn't affect his life insurance or disability insurance policies, but his recreational superhero activities would. Along with amateur boxing and bungee jumping, flying through space and punching through buildings qualifies hazardous activity according to insurers. Superman's life insurance policy might stipulate that if he gets killed doing his superhero duties, the benefit wouldn't pay out and the beneficiaries would get nothing. So $500,000 worth of life insurance coverage for Superman for 20 years might cost about 43 bucks a month. Now what if Superman gets hurt? If he wanted disability insurance in case he gets injured in any way and couldn't work, he could get, for example, $3,000 a month for up to 5 years to cover his expenses while he recuperates for about 84 bucks a month. Please note, because of Superman's hazardous activities, his monthly premiums for disability insurance are more expensive than the average guy's. A healthy non-smoker in his 30s who doesn't fly or skydive or leap over tall buildings in a single bound would pay $56 rather than $84. Super reasonable option.
Okay, does this look like I'm flying? Does this look like I'm flying? How about this? How's this? Oh, God.